In November of 2022, the world population reached a staggering 8 billion inhabitants. As newspapers scrambled to identify the newborn bearing the official title of 8 billionth baby, they skipped over an alarming yet related concern: the global population surge. By mid-century, our planet could be home to approximately 10 billion people. This clearly presents an issue. Unless we discover another habitable, accessible planet in our galaxy, we will need to devise measures to accommodate all of us right here on Earth. At some point, the question will inevitably surface: is year-round habitation in Antarctica a possibility? Antarctica, the only continent in the world without permanent human settlements, doesn't have an indigenous population like the Maoris of New Zealand or the Inuit of North America. Antarctica is around 13.66 million square kilometers of nearly inaccessible ice. Its average temperature is around negative 10 degrees Celsius and can drop as low as negative 80 degrees Celsius. Antarctica exhibits just two main weather patterns: a sunny summer, during which the sun never sets, and an equally lengthy, grim winter when sunlight is completely absent. Habitats at the South Pole experience either 6 continuous months of daylight or half a year of uninterrupted darkness. While it hosts no polar bears, Antarctica is home to leopard seals and penguins, though they mostly prefer to stay submerged rather than sliding over frozen sheets. Also, the continent lacks large trees or anything useful to gather. The only plant life are patches of algae and moss found along the coastal areas. Nonetheless, the continent's lack of predators and vast expanses of untouched land, ideal for agriculture, are appealing prospects for potential settlers. Nevertheless, no attempts have been made to establish permanent settlements in Antarctica. The first recorded foot set on the continent wasn't until the early 20th century by Roald Amundsen and his companions. They designated their shelter Polheim, or Home at the Pole, on December 14, 1911, but abandoned their campsite just 2 days later. Ever since, the continent has been primarily visited by scientists and tourists. 30 countries have established research stations there for study prospects, while tourists only visit during the summer months. Despite this minimal amount of human engagement, Antarctica is not suitable for human habitation. Even if you're a researcher studying the effects of climate change, the countless logistical and biological problems that come with an extended stay are hard to overlook. Consider the impact on your circadian rhythm from the irregular light patterns, or the harsh winds and extremely dry conditions. We simply lack the physiological adaptations, such as a significant fat layer like that of leopard seals and penguins, which would facilitate survival in such severe weather conditions. We do have greenhouses and nutrient-rich water to grow plants hydroponically, but to utilize this method sustainably would require expansive tracts of land. Introducing drastic changes to Antarctica could also further upset the balance of our planet's ecosystems. Despite appearing to be a vast white desert, the frigid cold of Antarctica plays a significant role in maintaining our globe's climate balance. Ultimately, it's not impossible to live in Antarctica year-round, but only for a select few who are equipped, trained, and determined enough to take on such a daunting task. Living in such an extreme environment is equivalent to living on the International Space Station. Despite our innovative capabilities, humans are simply not designed to survive, let alone thrive, in such harsh conditions. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.